Hey everybody, this is Joe and welcome to another episode of Joe DeRay's Cooks. Tonight I will be making mac and cheese. Not the mac and cheese that you get out of a box at your supermarket. This is the real deal. There are 7 different kinds of cheeses in there. There's bacon. All the ingredients are fresh. It's a lot of fun to make. It's super easy to make. Did I mention bacon? So let's stop talking and let's start cooking. Here's what you'll need. Pound of bacon. 5 cloves of garlic, minced. 2 cups of panko breadcrumbs. 1/2 cup of chopped fresh chives. 1/2 cup of fresh chopped parsley. 4 tablespoons of butter. 1/4 cup of flour. 3 cups of evaporated milk. Salt and pepper. Checkmate. 2 teaspoons of dry mustard powder. 1/2 teaspoon of cayenne pepper. 1 pound of cooked macaroni. 1/2 cup of cheddar cheese cubed. 1/2 cup of gruyère cheese, shredded. 1/2 cup of colby jack cheese, cubed. 1/2 cup smoked gouda cheese, shredded. 1/2 cup of provolone cheese, cubed. 1 cup of shredded cheddar cheese. And 1 cup of shredded mozzarella cheese.
Time to chop the garlic. Chopping parsley. Time to chop the chives.
You can actually eat chives raw. No kidding. So good. You could sprinkle salt on it, or just like this, but then you have sticky breath. Who is the character on an old TV show that used to eat these raw, and his friends would go, "Ew, onion." Come on, take a guess. Give up.
Why are you here, Romeo? You know it isn't safe.
Because I love you, Juliet.
Have you been eating onions?
When will you fly with me, darling?
Tonight.
Gotta love them little rascals. The first thing you want to do is get a large pot or a Dutch oven, put it over medium heat, and you want to cook the bacon crispy and the fat has rendered. You know, Jim Gaffigan, the comedian, is absolutely right. When you start to cook bacon, it's like an applause.
Bacon's the best. Even the frying of bacon sounds like applause. It's like, ah! Yay, bacon!
Now what you want to do, you want to add the garlic, the breadcrumbs, the chives, and the parsley. You want to stir it and cook the breadcrumbs until they're toasted, about 5 minutes. And basically what this is the topping. It's going to be super crunchy and super delicious. And it smells amazing. I could just eat this. That ought to do it. Now you want to remove this mixture and put it aside. At this point, in the very same pot, on medium heat, you want to melt the butter. And you want to sprinkle in the flour. And stir it out to combine. Add 3 cups of evaporated milk. You want to bring it to a simmer. Add salt and pepper. Mustard powder and cayenne pepper. Stir it up. You want a whisk to incorporate and smooth any lumps. The sauce should be thick enough to coat the back of the spoon. Yep. Next, you want to add the cooked pasta into the sauce and stir it good to combine it. Next, you want to add the cubed cheeses, the cheddar, the gruyère, colby jack, the gouda, it's getting hot, and the provolone. Then fold the cheeses into the pasta, and they're all just going to melt right in. If it's too dry, you can add more evaporated milk to your liking, and I think I'm going to do that here. Right now, you want to transfer the mixture to a baking dish. Now you want to top the pasta with shredded cheddar and mozzarella. The mac and cheese in the oven at 350 for 45 minutes until it's melted, bubbly, and golden brown on top. So there's about 20 minutes left, and I'm just gonna check it out. Wow, look at that. Now what I'm gonna do here is take it out and sprinkle the mixture that I made earlier. We're almost done, can't wait. All right, I think this is done. Let's take it out of the oven and take a look. Oh yeah. Oh yeah. Let me take you closer. It is boiling hot. Kind of looks like a Jackson Pollock painting, doesn't it? So there you have it, Joe's mac and cheese. We're just gonna let it sit for about 5 minutes, and then we're gonna cut them up into squares and ready to serve. Here's Jen.
Delicious.
Jen also made these plates. Check out Jennifer Daddio at Jen Daddio Pottery on Instagram. It does not come with the mac and cheese.
But it could.
But it could. So there you go. Joe's mac and cheese. Thanks for watching. I hope you'll try it at home. Let me know if you do. Let me know how it came out. I'm always curious, and I'm gonna dig into this now because I worked hard.